All in all, yeah, just it's quite early. I just finished washing. I just finished watching your video, boy. Yeah, I haven't watched the news or listened to the news or even read the news for a couple of weeks now. It's just too heavy. I get my news through you these days, I think. Yeah. I've heard this before, and I've even thought of it before, and it's been on YouTube. This sort of stuff, oh blimey, probably from when it started. That the government, even as like 9/11, I think that they were all behind that. There's too many loose ends. I think the government's probably do exactly what you're saying. A lot of these are probably paid mercenaries. As you're saying, they've got no army, got this, that, and the other. It's ruled through fear. It's an old thing, isn't it? I mean, if history is true, you go back 500, 600, 700, 800 years when our sort of level of people were like serfs with serf collars, and the kings ruled from the castles. They kept the people down by killings, fear, reputation, torture, and all the rest of it. Well, now it's probably still the same, but a little bit more subtle than that. Well, as far as we know. Look how many people still or were in Guantanamo Bay after since it well, since the 9/11. It's ridiculous, isn't it? But they could be funding all this. None of it could exist. It could all be made up, because I don't trust any of the news media. BBC, any of them, I think they're full of crap. They only tell you what they want to do or want you to know. Why is it, for instance, I've said before, excuse me, that if you don't pay your license to the BBC, it's a jail offence? A poxy news media thing? Well, if it's, are they a branch of the government? You know, I started off ordinary radio station way back in, was it in the 20s, whenever it was, and become part of it, you know, part of the government, whichever government's in, they're their branch, they're their mole, if you like. I've thought, you go through history, as I say, and there's always been mercenaries. I mean, they called them soldiers of fortune years ago. Soldiers of fortune. Mercenaries, kill for money. Wasn't much better than the mafia, really, when you think of it, with all the gangsters along the street, muggers and all the rest of it. But they probably do control the world, them and bankers. Whether they're the same people, who knows? I mean, the whole world's governed by money, which brings power. Once you can pay the rent, the rest of it's power, isn't it? Sort of thing, I've always said that. I can't, like, comment on it the other day, like, with Hitler. You know, they tried to get him to sign, well, he signed this piece of paper, and it still got World War II, but it's a different situation now. Hitler had all the armies, navies, and God knows what else, didn't he? As, I suppose, Napoleon and all the other people that invaded countries like Vikings, Romans, all the rest of it, like we did America. But as you say, where are they, ISIS? I mean, they've got no army, navy, air force, or whatever. Somebody, as you say, must be funding them. And who would have the money to fund something that big other than a government or amalgamation of a government? You know? I don't know about World War II. I mean, people like Churchill and that. I don't know, really, whether that was the same as this situation, funded or what. Then America didn't come in until they got whacked in Pearl Harbor, which is typical. I think it could be well what you say, that it could be just paid mercenaries, you know. If they do the torture and beheadings and that, if it's true, then they've got to be like Nazis, they've got to be psychopaths, money or not. I mean, I could do it. My son has looked at some of these beheadings, public beheadings, and he didn't. you know, what's the actual thing? He said, but they're like, what you see in the old West of the Red Indians, he said, they go absolutely berserk and work themselves up to a frenzied state. You know, they're probably drugged as well and all the rest of it. If it's true, he said, but, you know, well, as I've said, he said, if it's true, if it's not made up, I mean, you see an ordinary film with actors and that, to us, it looks absolutely real. I mean, even though we know they're acting. So, not beyond the realms of possibility. I didn't leave a comment, because I make this straight away. I've done that a few times with your ones. It is sad. I mean, as I say, I haven't watched the news for a couple of weeks. It just got too heavy, and I used to be a right news hound. Couldn't get enough of the news, like, you know. Don't want to know anymore. You did well. Not watching the telly for 24 years. You ain't missed nothing. Pathé News was on the films, wasn't it? Along with something called This Is Your Life that used to come on with it. Or so, I don't know. Small documentary. But it is a sad day. I don't know where it'll end. As you say, there's been a few things going back to Khrushchev and Cuba and that, hasn't it? It could have started a Third World War, I don't know. We somehow got over it all, but if the situation is as it looked then, it's different than it is now. What I mean is, if it's all the governments are trying to do this to create a Third World War, what I want to know is, why do they want a Third World War? Because the place would just be smashed up, wouldn't it? And if it's radiation, they reckon it can hang around for hundreds of years. So what are they going to do? Stay underground? You know, not come up to the surface. I don't understand the thinking behind it. Or it's all part of the fear factor. You know, if it doesn't exist in that way, then there's no civil war. It's all a stage act. You know, but if it is, if a bomb goes off, I suppose we won't know anything about it. I'm past caring about things like that now, to be honest with you. If we all come to an end, as long as there's no pain, I mean, I suppose because you get old and you know, you know, at my age, you haven't got a lifetime in front of you. God, when I was a kid, my dad inadvertently ruined a Christmas. What was I, 15, 16? I think it was work, yeah, and it was when something to do with Cyprus. Was it the Cuban Missile thing? I think it was something to do with Cyprus. And my dad, you know, he'd been through a war and all that. And he said, bombs and that dropped me. And he said, this could be a Third World War. And it resonated in me, didn't it? I kept thinking that a bomb, I didn't realise how big the atom bomb was then. You know, it could be just across the road where I have and everything would be finished and Christmas. It was so depressing that year. And I couldn't get out of my mind what you said. The whole thing went. I didn't go out. I didn't go out with my mates. Nothing. I was so depressed. Well, it's come a long way since then. So it don't bother me in that sense. But it's sad. If it does happen, it kills thousands of people. That is the sad part, yeah. Wholesale murder. What do they call it? Can't remember when they try and annihilate a whole nation. Like Hitler tried to eradicate the Jews, didn't he? Turns out there's Jews and were in his family anyway. I can't even what you call it. Oh, for God's sake. Oh, I nearly had it then. Genocide. You know? It will be worldwide genocide. So, in one way, I cannot see why governments would do it, because they're not immune to getting killed either. And the other way is, like we said, paid mercenaries to keep the people in line, if you like, keep people in check. Because control, it's like 1984, but a lot later than they thought it would be, like Big Brother and all that. You know, it's only the big boys. And the rest of us are fodder, which is what soldiers are, like you said before. You should bung Putin, Cameron, Obama, and can't think of the other one. Stick a man out, get him a gun, take all the troops out, and let them shoot each other, like, you know. Then there'd be some silly arsehole takes over from them, that's the trouble. You know, it ain't Putin, it'd be some other bugger from Russia and all the rest of it. No, really, we go around in circles. I don't know what the answer is, but you should, like you said, I don't know what the solution is. Is it? It's probably just a simple thing, like a matter of luck. Maybe you come out of it or not, because we can't control it, can we? No more than when they say, oh, you've got 6 months to live or something, cancer or something like that. You know, you can't say, well, I ain't going to have that, piss off. I don't fancy having that or dying. You can't do it, can you? It's out of control. It's out of your hands. So, day to day, I'm still not going to watch the news. I just can't be bothered with all, you know, people killing each other anyway and murdering on ordinary so-called civilized countries like this in America. People go out and shooting people because they just feel like it. You know, but you could be right about city centres this time of year. I mean, even the RIA used to pick Christmas and there's more people about. Honestly, we went to Blue Water because we had to take something back yesterday. Oh, God. I just saw them as absolutely stupid cows. The stuff they were buying, I mean, they're all fat as God knows what. Like, Blob's walking around and eating more food. The whole thing has gone to crap, like, you know. And the kids are, one kid, because he was, well, he was going to book and she was in Ari or St. Rosemont. And what did he do? I mean, the kid was only about 4 or 5. He just sat on the floor screaming. She had to pull him along. They let him get away with it. Other people hadn't smacked him one. Put him in the chair, you know, the wheelchair or something that he had, or pram. You know, at that age, they're dictating to their parents. So God knows what they're like. They're a bloody great teenager. They get guns and drugs. Oh. Just go around it. So, you know, if someone said to me I was going to live another 100 years, that'd kill me. Oh, we're not living in this poxy world right anymore, and this country's gone ridiculous now. You know, absolutely ridiculous. Anyway, back to basics. This is solar phases out slightly. And it's only about, what was it, 9:30 or so, so it's doing well, it's fine. I decided to stay in today, have a rest like a Sunday, I don't think I will go out for anything. Yeah. So there, look, so I should be off now, but it's great. Happy video, and you know, catch you further on down the line. I might even make some silly songs up about this, get you even more depressed then. Right, it's a goodbye for me and a hello to you. That's slightly wrong, but there you go. Bye for now.